Hi Gemini, this is Tracy from Northeast Tarot and welcome to your weekly tarot forecast for the week of September 17th through the 23rd. This is for Gemini Sun, Gemini Moon, and Gemini Rising signs. So Gemini, for this reading, I'm using the Hanson Roberts Tarot deck along with the Madame Indora's Fortune cards. Gemini, very interesting. At the bottom of the deck, Three of Wands. So I have a couple of threes here in the spread. So maybe some of you are dealing with a situation involving three people. That could be like a love triangle, but certainly does not have to be. It could be a family matter, could be a business matter. Three of Rods is you working very hard, investing a lot of time and energy into something. It's already taken root, it's already begun, but it needs time to grow. I'm definitely seeing that. So some of you have been working very hard towards a goal, towards something. You're very close, your ships are coming in, but there's still more work that's needed. Now what's interesting is the overall energy is the Three of Swords, which you have a lot of mental energy here, so I don't want you to think that this is automatically like loss and heartache. It can be, but for me, first and foremost, the Three of Swords can represent, yes, a difficult situation involving three people. Can also be an energy where you feel torn, very much torn or stuck, not knowing exactly what you should do. It's also mental frustration. It can be disappointment, severe disappointment. Now, what's interesting is the clarifying card is the Four of Cups, which is also an emotional energy. So we have this mental and this emotional energy. Four of Cups is someone who's not happy with what they're being offered, are not happy with the status quo. And so for some of you, you're being offered something here this week, but you might feel like it's a disappointment. It's disappointing. It's not exactly what you wanted. Now, for some of you, it still could be a blessing, especially if it's like a legal matter, which I'm definitely getting that for some of you. So you might have like a lawsuit that's pending, and you might be offered here this week like a legal settlement, and it's not exactly what you wanted. But if you wanted to put an ending to this, you could accept. For those of you that this has been a long journey and you just want it to end, you could accept. For others, I feel like the Three of Rods is representing, if this isn't good enough, if it's like a really low ball offer and it's just really not good for you, the Three of Swords is representing you still have work to do, but you're very close to your goal. So some of you, if it is a legal offer, a settlement offer, and it's not what you want, needing to listen to your intuition, because if you feel like you can fight even longer, harder, to get what it is that you deserve or what it is that you want, then go for it. Because with justice, justice will be served. Things are going to be made fair and equal for all parties. We have justice and we have the Ace of Swords. And so for those of you that have a legal battle that's ongoing, I do see a resolution that's, near. It's very close. And so the Ace of Swords is a card of victory, but it's victory after overcoming obstacles. And with that Three of Rods, it's like you're so close. You do have a victory that's coming in. I think that some of you have been waiting with the Seven of Pentacles here. You've been waiting. Seven of Pentacles is you planting those seeds and you working very hard, but those seeds needed time to grow. And so some of you, you've been working incredibly hard. And I think that because you've had to be patient, and maybe even at times felt like nothing was happening, maybe felt even a little stuck, that can explain this Three of Swords energy. I think that some of you are disappointed because something hasn't happened yet. Disappointed, even, with maybe an offer that is coming to you. But we have the King of Swords here. We have the King and actually the Queen of Swords as well in this spread. I think that, if you set your mind to it and you work hard and you don't give up, You know, I do feel like you're going to be successful, Gemini. We have two cards of victory here in this spread. We have the Ace of Swords, which is you overcoming obstacles, and then the Six of Rods here. Card of victory, success, triumph, you feeling proud of yourself. Could even be like some sort of public recognition. And so, you know, I feel like that's what you're moving towards. It's just a matter of time with the Seven of Pentacles and the Three of Rods. More energy, more effort is needed. And things are going to be made fair and right, and justice will be served. Now, for those of you that a relationship has ended, Three of Swords, for those of you that are resonating with it in this sense, with justice, you could be getting a divorce. Some of you could be using this sword and severing ties. But I think that if you're getting a divorce, you're waiting for it to be official. You're waiting for that divorce to go through. So I think that some of you are in that waiting period right now. Maybe it's because there's a lot of discussions or negotiations that are going on here with the Four of Cups. You could be offered something. Maybe you guys own like a lot of property or whatever it is together with the Four of Cups and then the Page of Pentacles here. Definitely news, information coming to you here this week. Some of you might have to make a decision whether or not you want to accept this offer that's coming to you. And then for those of you that it's not a divorce, you know, it could be a job opportunity, something on the financial front, something that's being offered to you. It might involve you signing something, a contract, a lease, something like that. I feel like some of you need some time to think about it. We do have this Eight of Swords energy, which is this mental energy that you have to overcome, which could be fear, confusion, fear. To be honest, what I'm getting with this is like a lack of confidence, a lack of self-confidence. Some of you are not happy in a situation, and it is time for you to move forward and move forward confidently. If you are involved in like a love triangle situation, and maybe you've been too nervous to get a divorce or too nervous to move on, whatever it may be, that's what I'm getting with this. It's like a fear, a lack of like confidence or self-esteem here. So that's really what's needed, is to definitely ground yourself. Because I feel like there's definitely a situation for some of you, and I'm definitely getting relationship. There's definitely a situation for some of you that I feel like it's not serving you and you're not happy, and maybe you haven't moved forward. I see the Eight of Swords as like a hindrance. Maybe you haven't moved forward because A, you're not ready. B, there might be, you know, some fear of the unknown. And so maybe grounding yourself, maybe working on building up your confidence, that might be needed for some of you. Obviously not all of you. This is a very specific reading, and I think I'm reading for two different groups of Geminis here this week. I definitely am getting some of you with, you know, a legal matter that's significant. And we do have a couple here, the King and the Queen of Swords. So you could be involved with a Libra, another Gemini, or an Aquarius, or just your match here. Maybe you met your match, King of Swords, Queen of Swords, you met your match. Okay, we have the Queen. This just shot right out. We have the Queen, love and prosperity. And so some of you, that's maybe what you're moving towards, love and prosperity, abundance in many forms. But if you are attached, you know, maybe, you know, this is what you're waiting on. This is what's coming through. I feel like that resolution is near. So some of you maybe need to use the sword, or it's just a matter of time. If you're waiting for a divorce to be final, you might have found new love. Maybe you're not completely happy because you're still tied. You know, that's what I'm getting for some of you. But you do have love, and you do have abundance. Gemini, you do have a lot to be thankful for. So, all right, Gemini, just move forward confidently. Try to stay confident. Try to stay out of your head, okay? I hope that you found this reading helpful. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. If you are interested in having a private reading, please check out northeasttarot.com. I wish you guys a great week.